Hello everyone, today we're going to be propagating this beautiful Gasteria little warty. This past fall I did some propagation out of this mother plant, and I still have some plants that came out of this mother plant. These are growing super healthy, as you guys can see. On this first one here, it's about 5 months old. And it's sitting on a 4-inch pot. The other one is sitting on a 6-inch pot and it's about 7 months old. So these are super slow growing plants. These are perfect if you're on a limited space or you want a plant that grows slow. These are perfect. There are two different ways you can propagate this succulent. The first one will be by offsets, which we're going to be doing today. The other one is going to be by seeds from flowers. As you guys can see, we already have some flowers, but they're not really mature. So that will be a future video where I'm going to be doing propagation out of seeds. For now, we're going to be doing out of offsets. Something that I would like you guys to notice is the color of my plant. You guys can see some purple here, and on this side you can see some really light gray. The reason for this color is because my plant is sitting on a full direct sunlight. My tree loses all the leaves during fall, so during winter and early spring this plant doesn't have any shade, but it's okay because during the summer it gets all the protection back from that tree. Now look at the difference in colors on these plants here. You guys see the colors are super green, and that's because these are been sitting in indirect sunlight. So you guys looking for indoor plants, these succulents will be perfect for that. The first step when propagating from offsets is going to be to remove your plant from your pot. In my case, I have it on the ground, so I'm going to remove it from the ground. The reason for that is because the offsets are super tight. They're super compact in there. And you try to remove it like that, you're going to be breaking some of the leaves. And you don't want to break the leaves on this type of succulent because they won't recover anymore. You have to end up removing the leaf, which you don't want to do. And later on, I'm going to show an example of that. But for now, we are ready to start removing the offsets. And what you want to do first is look for the biggest offset or the biggest baby. And you want to start from there. Once you remove the first one, the next ones are going to be super easy. But yeah, like the first one is always the hardest one. You have to like create the empty space and make sure you grab it like all the way from the bottom here. Kind of get a feel for it first. And you're gonna need some force on the first one here. There you go. And after you do the first one, the next one should come off way easier. Thank you. We are pretty much done with our first plant. And as you guys can see, we got several babies here. I think we got about 12 from one single plant, so that's really good. One thing that I wanna show you guys is the thickness of the leaf on this Gasteria. Look at how thick it is. So remember not to overwater this plant. You wanna water once every 2 weeks or maybe longer depending on your climate. And we are ready to start planting. And as usual, we're gonna be using our succulent soil. And I'm gonna be using 4-inch pots. I get these wall drain pots from Amazon. They're really cheap, they're about 10 cents, but they serve the purpose for propagation and growing plants. What I like about this type of succulents is that you don't have to wait to put them in pots. For most succulents, you have to wait a couple of days before planting, especially if you're doing cuttings. If you're doing cuttings, make sure you wait a couple to several days depending on the plant. But not for this one. In the past, I always plant them right away. Even if they don't have any roots, I put them in soil right away, and I never had any issues. I've never lost a single plant. So yeah, you're safe to do that. And this is pretty much the process that we use to propagate from offsets. If you want to stick around for more tips and watch me do the other plant, that'll be great. If not, I'll see you in the next video. And we have here our other plant. This one is smaller, but it has a lot of babies too. The offsets are actually smaller, but that's okay. And you follow the same process. One thing that is really, really important is that you avoid doing propagation during the summer. This type of succulent goes dormant during the summer, which means it goes to sleep, it kind of grows slower, it requires less nutrients. So avoid doing this during the summer. You can do it on early spring or after the summer, on early fall, and then you should be good. One thing that I want you guys to notice is this leaf here is damaged. It got damaged by my neighbor's dog when the plant was small. I never removed it, but as you guys can see, they will never recover. You had to remove them. I would have to remove the bottom babies here that are too small, but I had to remove them in order to remove this one. You kind of grab it from the bottom, move side to side, and then you should have a clean removal. I also left a few babies. The roots are still attached to the plant as well. And now it is time to replant our mother plant into the ground, into the soil. I'm gonna be removing some of the excess roots. Also, I'm gonna be putting more soil. I noticed that it didn't have enough soil, and that's because the plants were smaller and they didn't require a lot of soil. But now that they're bigger, I'm gonna put enough all the way around. If you have your plants in a pot, this is a good time for you to replace the soil as well. You can also cut the longer roots, and you can also use a bigger pot if the plant is bigger now. In my case, I'm not gonna be cutting the roots because the plants are gonna be in the soil. I just have to make sure that I put enough soil around the plants, and I should be good, and we're pretty much done. I'm gonna just clean them up. Some people use brushes to clean them up. I'm just gonna put some water in it, and that will do it. But thank you guys for watching, and hopefully I see you guys on my next video. Thank you guys.